What's up guys, I'm doing a skin giveaway every video. What you have to do to enter is like the video, subscribe to my channel, and as third, send your ID in the comments. The winners will be announced in the outro as you can see here in the bottom left. Good luck to everyone. What's up guys, welcome to the shoe guide. In this shoe guide you will learn how to play shoe perfectly, because shoe is at the moment, in my opinion, the strongest tank. And he can dominate the game, dive you on a tower and you have nothing to do against it. As you can see here, he dives with the immunity dash and just kicks the enemy to your team. And that's how you can get easy kills. You can dive towers like this very easy. So Shu is definitely a very, very important tank to play. Also, if your team doesn't have a Shu and the enemy team has, you are already in a disadvantage. So in this guide we will talk about the pros and cons of Shu, some general info, the abilities will be explained with the combos which are the most important of Shu, then a very good build, one tank build and one tank build with cooldown reduction, then we talk about the matchup of Shu, and then some gameplay with tips and tricks. So the pros and cons of Shu are that the high mobility of Shu is really a force to be reckoned with. Also the dash which gives immunity and the ultimate which also gives immunity are very strong. With the dash and the combos he has a very good engage and kick the enemy to your team, and so you can kill the enemy very easy. Shu is very hard to kill because she is very mobile and he gets a reset on his dash, as I will explain later in the abilities. When you play Shu, you think you're a Bruce Lee god and it feels goddamn amazing. The cons of Shu is that this combo can be interrupted when he is going into the enemy team. A simple stun that you miss with the dash to immunity it can be devastating and you will die very fast because of it. Also Shu is very hard to play because his combos are very fast and you have to click very fast on your screen. So Shu is a very mobile tank which engages with a great force and dive towers very easy. As you can see here in the strategies, you can see Shu can charge up his first two charges of the first ability, kick the enemy under the tower, and then with his passive he slows the enemy down and chases the enemy really fast. His main goal is just focusing the enemy squishy like this Eudora or a marksman and dive towers just to engage and kill enemies with the ultimate. So the first ability is called Only Fast. After moving you will get a passive stack and this will do 200% damage. So as you can see, you walk around and he gets passive again and gets a 200% damage buff. The first ability is called Yeet Kune Do. This ability you can cast it 3 times and this means you can charge it up and the third charge of the first ability will knock up the enemy. You can charge up the first ability 2 times in a push should enemy can't see it, and you can go out and push and use the knock up. The second ability is called Shenpo. You can use the dash and it will just dash a short distance. You can make this first ability and the second ability gets a reset. You can also dodge every spell possible in the game which makes me immune. Third ability is called the Wave the Dragon. It makes a roundhouse kick which will kick the enemy back. You can choose to follow up or not, and following up deals more damage. So for the combos, use your first ability, stack up that first, then dash in, use the knock up, dash again behind the target and kick him back into your team. As you can see here, they commonly use the combo here to kick this Eudora into his enemy team. So what you can do as the other combo is charge up again 2 times, then dash in, use flicker and use the knockback behind the enemy and you can kick him again into your team. After you kick him back, your first ability will be up again so you can use the knockback again. So as you can see here, he uses the same, he charges up, then flickers in, use the ultimate to kick him back into the tower and then follows him up to get the kill. So for the first build, this is a very tanky build with no cooldown reduction. Cooldown reduction is not really needed, but it is useful for a Shu. This is the main build for Shu, so be sure to use this. Always use flicker so you can use the combos as I said before. So the first item will be armor boots, then some damaging magic resistance item, with a thorn mill or a blade armor which will counter basic attacks. Then the fourth item will give a big shield so you can go in more easy. Second last item gives tanky abilities but also a lot of damage, and their last item will be the immortality to revive yourself. The second build is the cooldown reduction build. The first boots will give you 10% cooldown reduction. The same for the second item, which also gives you 10% cooldown reduction and gives you healing on all the spells, which Shu uses a lot. The third ability is plate armor to get a lot of armor. The fourth item will give you a lot of damage around you and also magic resistance. The fifth item gives you 10% cooldown reduction again and gives also a bit healing and magic resistance and HP. The last item again is immortality to revive yourself when you die. So Shu only has two counters. The first counter is Nana, because she can transform you, and dashing the transform will be very difficult because you cannot see the animation casting of Nana when she transforms you, so it's very hard to dodge the transform. This transform interrupts your combo, and that's why you will die very fast, because you cannot do anything and cannot cast any spells. So the second counter is scary, because she has a 2-second cooldown dash, and this dash will just keep her away from you. So Gary can dash every time away from you when you have to go in. And yeah, it's very hard, even with Flicker, to counter her. Because Gary almost always has Purify, so she can purify your ultimate or knockup or anything. So she will just dash around you, and with her insane damage, she will just burst you down very fast. So now, there will be a gameplay of Shu and some tips and tricks. One thing I almost forgot to say was, you have to use Hero Lock Mode. You have to enable it before you go into game. Hero Lock Mode will let you change targets. So when you go in into a full team, you can quickly press the hero you want to focus, and you can use the ultimate on the hero you want to focus. This requires a lot of skill, because you have to push the buttons really, really fast, and it's very advanced. But it's a very must, because you don't want to kick a Tigreal into your team, because then your team will die. Let's take a look at the gameplay of Dekomeli. So he's playing Shu. He doesn't have his new skin yet, but guys want a new skin of Shu is pretty awesome. My last video, you can also see the skin, and I really like the side. So he's going bottom lane with the Cyclops. And I don't know if Cyclops will buy a jungle item. I think he's checking if his team will buy it, but he'll just buy it. He doesn't buy the jungle item since he's the tank. So they start the red buff first. The common lead is playing on the iPad, so as you can see, his vision is a lot bigger than on phone. And I think that's really OP when you play on iPad or any tablet, because you can see so much further. But in this gameplay, you will really see what combos he'll use, and Dekomeli is a very, very good Shu player. And that's why I wanted to some gameplay with him, because you can really see what a good Shu player can do for your team. So, since Shu is a tank, he'll give all the jungle XP and gold to the marksman normally, but this time it's Cyclops. So he's when he's level 4, he will play really aggressive, and that's very useful, because he can just go in and ultimate someone under the tower, even at level 4. So they grouping here. So he's being aggressive, yet he's just zoning off the enemy for the crab. So they're taking the scrap here very free. Here, the enemy's not even coming, because they know they can. So there are 4 men in the full lane of him already. It's 3. He's almost level 4. Level 4 he will probably dive, but he doesn't have enough XP yet. After this wave he'll be level 4, so I think he will dive here. Still waiting. Yeah, Cyclops, Team Cyclops was scared here. There was no point to flicker away, so I think he will ultimate. He'll ultimate soon. Yeah, he will ultimate behind. He dashed behind Yun Zhao and kicks the Yun Zhao back to his team and get a kill. It's look at how he's just diving this Cyclops. But doesn't really matter. He's always playing really aggressive. I mean, if Shu, you can play really aggressive. He should have dodged the tower shot, to be honest. As it seems, the Cyclops has come back to base already. So if you want to move fast, you should always dash, use your first ability and dash again when you go to lane. It helps a little bit if going back to lane faster. We is advancing on the shoe. Okay, so the enemy shoe kicked him back. That was not really necessary. Okay, so he messed up the kick because the enemy shoe actually dodged the kick. And he dodged the knockup of the enemy shoe, so it looks like they are both good shoes so far. So the Gumbly is just looking at the map, where to help the team. Because at the moment there is no enemy to gank, there's no enemy to attack, so he's still just looking around the map where he can help the team. Because with you, your ganks are really good. You can just stack up your first ability in the push, then you can go with the flicker or just your dash. You can engage out of the bush, and you can't really see it coming. So he is going on the Yun Zhao here. He takes a tower shot, and I think he will kill Yun Zhao here. His first ability here, and he keeps going on the cycle. I think this team will get flickers into the bush, but I don't think he will escape. He'll get the double kill. It's crazy. But as you saw, what combo he used, he stacked up his first ability, then he dashed into the Yun Zhao and kicked him when he was on the tower. Now they are going on the Lolita, but I don't think he'll kill him. He should go back to base. As I said, he's really playing aggressive, so he'll dash behind it, took the combo, it's perfectly, and now they kill him. He stacked up the first ability again, and then he dashed into the Lolita. And then he gets the reset of the dash behind Lolita and use the ultimate. That's what you really should do. If you want to see the combo again, just watch the video again to practice it. Because it's the most used combo at the moment. Dash in. He could have killed Ari, who didn't. His ultimate was down, so he couldn't kill the Cyclops here. Also, it's pretty risky because the enemy shoe was there also. Okay. I think, in my opinion, he should have flickered behind the Cyclops and used the ultimate. That would have been best. And also, he should have dodged the ultimate with the dash here. If you want to make it perfect, you should watch those little things. It's pretty important. But as I said, Chu is very hard to play. If you want to practice him, you should have practiced him a lot because there are so many things you can optimize in your game. So he's stacking his first ability in the bush, as I said, and he's going in. He's saving his ultimate for when he really needs it. In this case, it's the Yun Zhao. He's still going for the Yun Zhao. I think Yun Zhao will die here. It's 1v3. He might die here, actually. Gets the kill, Yun Zhao flickers away. Really well played. He knocks up the enemy and then dashes out of it. And he's actually escaping now. But the Gumbly, he never. He always wants to go. Yeah, he really goes back to base now. Well played. It's also really well played by Gumbly. So when you go back to base, he's always checking where to help, so he's going with the Moskov now. I think because he's pushing solo, he wants to help Moskov so he doesn't die. As you can see, he's using the first build as described in the guide. He actually gave me the build, and I think it's the best build to really tank. You don't die fast, and it also does a little bit of the damage. You can actually get 1v2, 1v3 with that build, that's crazy. So he's helping middle, now they will take middle tower, take a lot of gold. Will he go on the shoe? They are actually going on the shoe. Will they kill him? I think the shoe will kill him. But there's no point, I think he can kill him. Yep, got the kill. So now he's really tanky. Got the blade armor, he got another magic resistant item, and he got the boots, tanky boots, so he's already really, really tanky. So I think Lolita's ultimating. Okay, that does a little bit of damage. Like, he tanks the Lolita ultimate and he almost takes no damage, that's crazy, just the build. So he's ultimating Lolita, doesn't really matter how he ultimated, it just ultimated. For the stun. Let's see what the Lordy will do now. Just farming a bit. Nothing really happening. They should do the turtle. Yes. What Shu does here is you should you should understand. He didn't help the turtle, but he's actually was waiting in the bush. So if anyone came to the turtle, he could have fighted them, and so they wouldn't go to the turtle. And they can do the turtle free. It's called zoning. It's really important. Just to let enemies don't go to the turtle. Don't make them come close. So again, he's going back to base. As you can see, he has no cooldown reduction with the build, but on Shu, the cooldowns of the abilities are pretty low already, so it's not really necessary. And building cooldown items, if you build cooldown, you're not as tanky as this build, so it's a risk you'll take. And the main part of Shu is just going in one time with your ultimate, kicking back the enemy. So that's your main goal, so you don't really need cooldown reduction. Okay, so he's getting on the Cyclops, he will kick him now. But he got knocked up, so he couldn't follow up on the ultimate. He's 1 versus 2, Shu and Lolita. You can clearly see he's a stronger build, he's more tanky than the enemy Shu. But his Freya does a lot of damage, always be careful that he knocked up Freya. She couldn't do anything. Dash over the wall. It's very important to use your dash over the wall. It's long enough to go over the wall, so you should do that. I think he'll go in. He's going into the bush, no one sees him. Now he will go in to kill the Cyclops, probably. Yeah, he's focused the Cyclops. His team cannot finish him off. And that was too risky for Shu to do the damage himself. So he went back. Team didn't finish off Cyclops. That was, I think, it was their bad. I think this Freya will die. This diving way too aggressive. Well, it was very, it's very hard of Shu to go back because if he died here, and Roger and Karina were all low HP. If he died here, they could have gotten the inhibitor tower probably, and maybe even ended the game just like that. That was not necessary because they are actually ahead of the game. And they just lost a team fight, but that's not really a problem. He's getting kicked here. Will he get out? Look at this bitchy. Very low HP, he'll dash out. And he's actually getting out the Lolita. First ability of Lolita didn't connect to him. And he actually survived this. That was nice. When you use your ultimate, you're immune to everything. No one can target you, so you'll take no damage. So you really gotta use that when you're low HP, just use your ultimate or anything. Just do whatever you can. So they're chasing the Lolita. Look, they just almost aced the enemy. Only Freya is left alive, and Yun Zhao will revive soon. That's a little comeback here. They should go take care of bottom lane maybe. So he's short calling, saying let's do the lore together. This enemy is down, which is a really good call to be honest. And yeah, he'll just start it. So in solo queue, when you go solo queue, you just have to start it. Just say this and start it, because no one will come if you don't. And it's pretty easy to kill. With Karina, you can kill the Lord really, really fast. So they take it free. They have no time. The enemy has no time to react on it. Almost everyone of the enemy team is in the top lane, so they are moving to the top lane. He's waiting in the bush. What will he do? Gets a two-man knock up. He ultimates who? The Freya. So this Voskov has to be careful. It will kill the Freya probably. Yes. Okay, nice. So they get one kill here. He's still going. Roger is still going. I think he'll go in here. He's knocked on Lolita. I should have knocked up Yun Zhao, but it's fine. 4 seconds cooldown on the ultimate. He knows it. He'll dash this ultimate probably. Yes, immune. That's really nice. He'll go Flecker in, kicks the Shu back. I think Shu will die here. Well, Shu is very low HP as well, but Yeah, he dashed out of the turret. He didn't get the final shot on him, so he survived. And he recalls in the back. So they managed to get 3 kills, and I think they will end the game here. If 2 enemies left, they might even... Yeah, they're going back. They're low HP, Cyclops low HP, Korean's low HP, so they cannot push for the victory yet. So they gotta wait, they gotta recall, they go back to base, and they'll go in. So I think they will go on the Cyclops here. But Cyclops is too far away, he couldn't reach him. But I think he'll go again on the Cyclops. Dash it. The dash on the ultimate was not good. Okay, so he'll probably dash in. Still not in range. Immune. Okay, he's tanking some tower. Like, he's ultimating now just to... so the tower didn't focus him anymore. And get out of tower range. So the friendly Cyclops died. Enemy Karina, his Karina has split pushing in the bottom lane. They are taking the turtle now. I think they will defend bottom now since Karina was there. And so they take the free turtle now. As I said, yep, they are going bottom now. Mid lane is also pushing. They should focus bot lane or mid lane, or top lane to take another inhibitor. So shoe vs shoe fight here. A little short shoe vs shoe. You see the 1v4 now, Greenhead's coming. Let's see what they will do. Roger, okay, so Roger and top lane, they will all come for Roger. That's really obvious. And I hope Roger will escape. Shu is trying to help him, but it's too late. Roger is dead, he escaped over the wall. So that's 3v5 now, alive. Fort Moscow's also dead. Just that, so let's see how they will defend this. I think there will be no problem with the Cyclops, they have enough damage to clear the wave. Cyclops is just ultimating, nothing anything really. So will he go in? That's the question. I think he's checking how fat everyone of the enemy team is so they can go in. But it's 4v5 now, he's go flickering in. Focusing the Freya, and Freya has no escape here, he will die. Vegeta is just here, he's focusing. Someone else who walked away. Amy Shu is dying as well. Now he'll just slow down and knock up the enemy Lolita. And Lolita will also die. There's 4 kills on the friendly team. Also, played this really well. And Shu also, he went and killed the Freya, was a high priority target. So now it's only this Cyclops left alive, and he'll go into him, walk behind the Cyclops and kick him to any friendly team. So this is GG, guys. He really used the combo as well of Shu, as you could see. So I hope you learned a lot from this gameplay, because it's very nice to see how he uses the combos and just see some actual Shu gameplay where he presses the buttons. So you'll get the MVP here probably. He got 0 deaths, he played this pretty well. He should have dashed the ultimates of Cyclops, and he should have dashed with the immunity more, but it was a good gameplay. Anyway guys, I hope you enjoyed this Shu guide, I hope you learned a lot, and I will see you next time.